self-destruct. When it comes to the best, it ain't hard to choose. When your sport shows up, dates and interviews, the only way is the right way, I might say.
Welcome back, everyone, to the TWSN Tailgate Show. Again, we are not live this week, but we do have a recorded show for you. This time, we're breaking down the College Football Award predictions. This is always a fun topic to discuss, to break down. Everyone's looking forward to it. We did our Heisman draft as well. This is going to be strictly awards, non-Heisman. But let's get straight into this. I mean, this is something we've been looking forward to. Harrison, I'm going to go to you first. Who is going to win the award for the best quarterback this coming season?
I think the guy who's going to win the O'Brien Award for the best quarterback is going to be the guy who's going to throw for the most yards in college football this year, the quarterback of maybe the best offense in college football history. That's C.J. Stroud, quarterback for Ohio State. I think this could be kind of similar to what we saw with LSU 2019, just with a better offensive line. Ohio State has one of the best offensive lines in the sport. They have one of the best running backs in the sport, the best wide receiver in the sport, and then C.J. Stroud, probably the first or second best quarterback, going to throw for a lot of yards. This team's going to score 40, 50 points per game, and C.J. Stroud is going to be the focal point of it. So he's going to be the best college football quarterback in 2022.
Yeah, I mean, I think I'm going to agree with you on that. I think it's definitely going to be Stroud as well. I mean, we saw what he did without Garrett Wilson, without Chris Olave. Granted, it was a one-game sample size, but it was still impressive nonetheless. I think he's going to come into the season. I think this entire Ohio State team is going to want some redemption for what happened last year. I'm going with Stroud to win this as well. Rob, are you going 3-for-3, or are you going to stray from this?
So my quarterback of the year, just like these two guys also, is C.J. Stroud. At the end of the day, that offense is way too explosive for them to not give the award to him. Unless we see some kind of regression from him, which I highly doubt. There's no way that, you know, he does not win this award, especially with the crazy weapons they also have on the outside. Like, we haven't even named all of the receivers from the recruiting classes the last 2 to 3 years that they've been, you know, cooping up. So I think this is easy. Let's go C.J. Stroud.
Yeah, so we went 3-for-3. I mean, not much else to really say about that. Let's move on to the Doak Walker Award, Best Running Back. Harrison, take it away.
This is a more of an outside-the-box one, but this is one of my favorite players in the sport. I think I had him like 14th in my top 25 offensive players going into 2022. Kansas State running back Deuce Vaughn. I think he's the best pass-catching running back in college football. They're going to utilize him so much, especially with Adrian Martinez there, who's now coming over from Nebraska. He's going to be kind of like an Alvin Kamara-ish like role, offensive coordinator Colin Klein. They're going to find every different way to give Deuce Vaughn the football because he's the focal point of the offense. He is electric in the open field. He's so much fun to watch. He's not Bijan Robinson. He's not kind of Braylon Allen, but he's just a different style of player, and I'm picking him to win the Walker Award.
I like it. I agree. He's going to be fun to watch. I'm going to go a little bit of a different route, so we're finally straying away from this, but I'm going to go with Zach Charbonnet from UCLA. I absolutely love this kid. Like, he is going to have such an awesome season for the Bruins. I mean, he breaks tackles. I think he needs to be their workhorse, basically. And I think he can do it. So I think he's going to kind of come out of left field a little bit, and he's going to win this award. And for the first time, UCLA will have something to cheer for in a long time. But I'm going over to you, Rob.
For running back of the year, I'm going to go with Blake Corum from Michigan. I think that the offense this year is going to be way more centered around him. I don't love what they're doing at quarterback. I also think that they have a ton of regression from last year because they lost a ton of players, and I just see no way that they Michigan repeats the same success they had from last year.
All right, yeah. I mean, so he's going with Corum from Michigan. So guys, we all pick different people. So it'll be fun to revisit this at the end of the season. Next up, we have the best wide receiver. Now this one is going to be interesting because I think I know where you're going with this, Harrison. But I'm curious to see if you switch. So who are you going with?
Well, if you saw our Heisman Trophy video last week, you would see who I picked to win. My first overall pick to win the Heisman Trophy. And if he wins the Heisman Trophy, he's probably going to win the Biletnikoff Award for the best receiver. So I'm going with none other than Jackson Smith and Jigba, Ohio State wide receiver. Just not much else to really say. He's going to have 2,000 yards in that range. He's by far the best wide receiver in the sport. He showed it having, 326 yards in the Rose Bowl against Utah. He's with Garrett Wilson, Chris Olave gone, the ball is going to have to go somewhere. And I expect more targets for him, more touchdowns for him as well. Only had like, I think, 11, 12 last year. That number could be closer to 20 in 2022. So, yeah, comfortably, I feel very good about Jackson Smith and winning the Blitnikoff Award.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely think he's probably the favorite. So I don't blame you for picking him. You did go the way I thought you would. Yeah. So I'm glad. I'm glad that I was able to, you know, figure that out.
You're obsessed with that out.
Yeah. So I'm going to go a different route. I'm going to go down to Baton Rouge, and I'm going to take Kayshon Boutte. He is recovered from his injury. He is their big play machine. I think he is going to have a hell of a season. Like, this kid might be the best receiver coming in to the NFL draft next season, and I think he's going to show it this year. So I'm going with Kayshon Boutte to win this award and bring home some pride for the LSU Tigers.
For wide receiver of the year, I'm going to go with Xavier Worthy. I know it's a little bit of an outsider pick almost, but he's got a better quarterback than he did last year, and he still had 1,000 yards and 12 touchdowns last season. He's got the former coach of the Biletnikoff winner, Brendan Marion, was the coach at Pitt last year with Jordan Addison. I think it's a great recipe for success. Out of all the wide receivers, I feel like he has a very underrated shot at winning.
I think that's a great pick. That was actually going to be one of my picks as well. I thought about it. Harrison, we're moving on to the Thorpe Award. I think this is going to be a really interesting pick here for you. So I'm curious, where are you going with this?
There's a lot of really good defensive backs in college football this year. Obviously, Kelee Ringo for the Georgia Bulldogs had the game national championship ceiling pick six, but he's actually not my choice. This is a player I liked a lot last year who was going kind of under the radar. And I'm not just promoting him because I think both of his parents follow me on Twitter. But I'm going with Clark Phillips III, cornerback from Utah.
I knew
he
it.
He was very good last year as a true freshman. One of the best man-to-man corners in all the Pac-12. And now that Utah's kind of like on the map, I want to say, they're going to be a top 6-7 team preseason. They have big games against Florida, USC, UCLA. You'll kind of see more of Clark Phillips in the spotlight, more national attention because Utah's not this team coming out of nowhere. They're kind of already at the top. People are going to realize that he's one of the best corners in the sport. I had him in my top 10. Defensive players in college football. So I think he's going to win the Thorpe.
I knew it. I knew you were doing that, and I hate you for it because he was my pick as well. I'm still going to go with him. I'm going with Phillips. I think he's a stud. Like he had 61 tackles last year. Like you said, with Utah kind of coming into that national spotlight now, people are going to know who he is. And I definitely think he's going to, shine, and this Utah team is going to be very good. Despite all the stuff we throw at you for loving Utah. But, I think Phillips is going to really break out this year. So I'm going with him as well. Anthony, you going 3 for 3?
For defensive back of the year, I'm going to go with Riley Moss from Iowa. He has 10 interceptions in the last 4 years. We thought he was going to declare last year. It looked like almost a lock, and he decided to come back for a fifth year. This is one of the better defensive backs in the country. A lot of people are forgetting that he even came back. All the success that he had the last few years. I'm loving this pick. I think it's one of the easier ones. I like Kelee Ringo too. I have a feeling that he's going to get thrown at less because of the less experienced players that are going to be playing on Georgia's defense this year because of the amount of players that got drafted from last year's defense.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely think that's a good pick. We're going to go on to the best defensive player here. I feel like we're all going to pick the same person, or at least we all should, you would think, but I'm curious. Harrison started off for us.
I'm not going to waste anybody's time. Will Anderson is by far the best defensive player in the sport. He was the best defensive player last year. He would have been the first pick in the draft, and he is without question going to win the defensive player of the year.
That's I agree. All. Not going to say much else. Anthony, you going with anyone other than Will Anderson, or no. Are you going to? Okay, so we'll move on. We all picked Will Anderson here. I think we all know Will Anderson's the best defensive player in the entire nation. So this next one's kind of interesting to me. It's the best coach. And, we all know Nick Saban's probably the best coach in the sport. But he doesn't win this award all the time. Like, Luke Fickell won it last year. So, I'm curious, Harrison, who is going to be your best coach who wins this award?
There's two guys I'm really torn between.
I swear if you steal my guy.
I think I might have yours. There's two guys I'm torn between. They're both going to have their own success separately. But it's not too long ago that they were together. And I think Brian Kelly in his first year at LSU
you didn't steal mine.
Is in for a they're going to be a lot better than people think. I have LSU at 10-2 this year, as we mentioned on the video a couple weeks ago. They're going to be incredibly good. And I think Brian Kelly, everywhere he's gone, he's had success. 14 of the last 15 years, he's won 8 games somewhere. I think LSU could win 10, make it to a New Year's Six Bowl, really compete with some of the top teams. Brian Kelly, coach of the year. I was going to choose Marcus Freeman. That was the little option.
So Marcus Freeman is my pick. So okay. I'm glad that you went with Kelly. Yeah, I'm very high on Marcus Freeman. I'm high on this Notre Dame team, and that's something I'm not used to saying because it seems year after year Notre Dame just lets people down. They don't either make it, and then they lose. But then again, Brian Kelly's not there anymore. So under a different regime here, I think we'll get into this more, but I think they're going to beat either Ohio State or USC. They're going to beat one of them.
They're not beating Ohio State.
You also said that about Oregon.
I know. I knew you were going to say that.
What happened? We'll talk about this.
I don't know what happened. You tell me.
I'm pretty sure Oregon went into the shoe and beat Ohio State. And who called that, guys?
Well, we'll talk about this. If next week you want to pick Notre Dame to beat Ohio State, go ahead and do it at your own risk.
The same thing about Oregon. But we'll talk about that. But yeah, I'm going with Marcus Freeman. I think he's a hell of a coach. He's going to rally the troops. I'm high on this Notre Dame team. So Marcus Freeman is going to win this award. Anthony, finish this off.
Coach of the year. I'm going to make it easy. I think it should go to Nick Saban. He's going to have an undefeated year. When you look at the Coach of the Year awards last few seasons, it's kind of gone to coaches who have overachieved what they took like expectations. I just have a feeling that Alabama's just going to be on a crazy revenge tour after we saw what Saban and all the players thought about last year's participation trophy, which was making the college football playoff. I think that they're going to run through anyone they play and just the amount of dominance that they show. You got to give the award to someone who is as good of a coach as Saban. He could really get it every year for how good he's been. So I'm going to go with Nick Saban.
I mean, it's not a bad pick at all. We all know he's probably the best, so it's deserving. But that's going to do it here for our college football award predictions. We will be back to break down week 1, guys. We are so close. We're almost there. Just hold on a little longer here. But thank you guys for watching this. Make sure to tune into the TWSN Tailgate Show every Saturday morning, 11 a.m. Eastern Time on the TWSN YouTube page, through Twitter. Subscribe to our Patreon. We're going to be putting on college football plays. Make some money, guys. Just make money. I promise you, you're going to make money betting on college football this year. Harrison's doing it. Anthony's doing it. So we will see you next week when we break down week 1 of the college football season.